to the last mile. As per the announcements in the last four or five weeks, the liquidity, as was discussed today, was not any major issue with the NBFCs, microfinance institutions and anyone. There were straight agreement that this is the time, festival season is coming. So therefore, it was the time to speed up and step up the efforts to do far more efforts to reach to the customers who need the credit as per the prudential norms which are there. The NBFCs and MFIs in particular raised certain issues for easing that process in terms of using the KYC changes for communication and taking the old address. That solves the problem of the migration and also various other things when the jobs are changed or that. The vehicles, housing, they all express that there is robust demand and liquidity is also not an issue. Therefore, they have all decided to join in the outreach program and step up their efforts in various districts. The government, as the Finance Minister announced last Friday, in 400 districts there would be an outreach program. The outreach program is essentially to just go to the districts and convey that banks have sufficient liquidity, so as the NBFCs, and therefore it's an outreach for potential lending to those who want to take loan. It's not any kind of a relaxation of norms there. It is just that after the last announcement of the Finance Minister, there was also the enabling provision from the CVC saying that the commercial decisions, and there would be a fine distinction between commercial decisions and otherwise, and a committee was set up. So there is no fear psychosis as such, and there is no liquidity issue. So it's an outreach, and to take advantage of the festive season, this outreach program has been organized. We'll be putting the list of the districts on our website tomorrow or day after. The first round would be in around 250 districts where all banks will participate, and they will work in along with the NBFCs and HFCs and microfinance institutions so that they can leverage the last mile connectivity which the MFIs, NBFCs and HFCs have. And in turn, these institutions can take advantage of the liquidity which banks have. So it's a kind of win-win situation for both, and therefore the efforts would be to establish these camps and do it for 3 days from 3rd to 7th September in 250 districts. List of districts would be on the website so that everybody can know in advance. The second phase will also start and extend in periods till Diwali. So this is the usual time. In any case, banks and others do their outreach program during this time. The other issues raised by some of the MFIs and the HFCs regarding the rate at which they get the refinance have also been noted. They also raised the issue of the SIDBI and NABARD doing their external benchmarking while doing the refinance have also been noted and would be looked at. So this is in nutshell the entire.
That okay?
Sir, ek baar hindi mein bata
dein. Basic samjhe. Alag se bata dein.
Theek. Is that all right? I just want to add a few points. Everything that we've heard here is what is being said. It's not Government of India's viewpoint which is being voiced. The summary of what we've heard from the NBFCs, mutual funds, and also the private sector bank is, some of them are here, so in their presence I would like to say, I have not heard liquidity as a problem from anybody. That is one thing which I want to take as a message. If anything, more liquidity reaching them, they see a demand waiting there and they wouldn't mind extending further facility. However, they have some reservations because of given RBI rules, like they can't participate in a co-origination related exercise with another bank because of certain restrictions put on them by the Reserve Bank. So that is one of the main things, for example, which has come up, saying if only that wouldn't be curbing us, we'll be able to extend more loans. There is a demand. One point I'd like to highlight here is many of the MFIs and microfinance units which have come here are in the deep country. They are in absolutely rural, densely populated rural areas, whether in the north or in the south or in the west. So almost near unanimity prevailed that in those areas there's still demand, there's still activity going on, and they're going on extending their loans. And many of them, in fact, I was in a light-hearted way telling them, because each suggested that we are growing at 10, we are growing at 20, and so on. I said I'll be very glad to see placards of what is the growth, because all of them clearly voiced positive growth, which is a good encouraging story. Particularly for the small finance banks, it seemed as though they are going on a smooth path. They've not had a friction or a blip in the last 1 year. So the issue is, if more money reaches the rural pockets, there's more demand and they can service. So liquidity, I repeat, I didn't hear from anyone telling me there is a crisis or there's a shortage of liquidity. That's one message which came across. The other is, many of them are dealing in rural areas, many of them are dealing with SHGs, many of them are dealing with women particularly. So any other issue related to that, which is a step in wanting to relax further norms, like for instance, we had Bandhan Bank's chief who's here telling us about women who are their large customers, large number of customers are women. If they move from one place to another because of marriage or because of relocation, to get their new address becomes an issue. So he's not worried about, I'm unable to lend. He says practical problems about, you know, logistics or moving, addresses shifting, things of that kind were the issues. In fact, many of them were talking about what we can do further to relax for them to get going with their business. So largely, one other opinion which prevailed is affordable housing scheme, which the government has launched, is really taken off well. In fact, there's a desire from some of them saying instead of 45 lakhs, can it be raised to 50 lakhs so that that can be included. Segments which want 50 lakh also can be helped under the affordable housing. One observation which I heard, which I'm repeating, it's not my voice, that the commercial vehicle related problem, people not coming forward to buy as many commercial vehicles, is seen as a cyclical problem, is seen as a problem which is not new, which happened sometime in 2010 or so. So the private bankers and also the NBFCs, which are specializing in lending for commercial vehicles, feel that it is a problem which will be gotten over in the next one or two quarters. It has happened before, it is now again.